Good morning. Dignitaries, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to welcome all of you to Samagam 2018, the first vibrant amalgam of representatives and veterans from various walks of lives who've come together to create greater visibility for the work that the development sector is doing and to invite greater support to address the issues of equality and justice in society. We begin this morning with a formal introduction and welcome address by Madam Anshu. Anshu Vaish is a retired officer of the MP Cadre. She was Secretary of School Education and Literacy before she retired.
Namaskar. It's really nice to see everybody here this morning. And I'm privileged to welcome you all to Samagam 2018 on the occasion of the Founders' Day of PRADAN. We celebrate 35 years of PRADAN's life today, and we do this by reflecting not on the achievements of PRADAN alone, but on those of civil society as a whole. We know that civil society organizations encounter many challenges in their pursuit of social transformation, but their sheer grit and determination in the face of those challenges is what Samagam 2018 seeks to celebrate. We are here today to recognize what civil society organizations have accomplished despite the difficulties with which they cope while working with remote and disempowered communities. And we are here because we believe in the potential and the capacity of civil society to bring about change in the lives of those communities. However, there is also a need to adjust the nature and role of civil society organizations as times change. And Samagam seeks to provide a platform for deliberations on just such issues. Part of my brief today is to talk about PRADAN, to introduce PRADAN to everybody, but I know that much of what I'm going to say is not new to most of you. Nonetheless, on a day like this, it does need to be said. Professional Assistance for Development Action, PRADAN, was founded in 1983 by two young professionals, Deep Joshi and Vijay Mahajan. They believed that India's development cause would be well served by empathetic young people with a good professional education, dedicating themselves at the grassroots to create a just and equitable society. They were convinced about the potential of professional and technical assistance for rural livelihoods to alleviate poverty and empower communities. This was PRADAN's vision, attained through strong collectives of women supported by PRADAN, but encouraged to manage their own affairs and take charge of their own lives. These collectives, whether they were self-help groups or their federations or producers' organizations, are the leaders of the processes of change. PRADAN believes in linking communities with the mainstream, not in creating parallel structures or insulated channels, which would be dependent upon NGOs and donors for their continued survival. The women's collectives challenge patriarchy and existing power structures. They take up issues with panchayats. They fight for their entitlements under government schemes. So the whole effort is to fight within the mainstream and with the mainstream. These women's collectives strive at all times to carve for themselves spaces in which they can live and work with dignity. At a Mahila Sammelan that I had attended in Kesla, Madhya Pradesh, many years ago, the positive energy of the participants was truly infectious. Hundreds of women had attended, and for me that was among the first such experiences. So hundreds of women had attended, each was fighting her own battles to overcome her deprivations and to better her condition. But as members of robust women's collectives, they were also confident of their own capacity to demand their due, and they were all hopeful about change. This was the most striking thing about that Sammelan. And even more striking to me was the fact that the women and PRADAN came across as partners. That was really my first up-close and personal encounter with PRADAN's belief system. And I realized that Pradhan's focus was, and it still is, on internal strengthening of the women's collectives while assuring them long-term support. And importantly, the women expect nothing more than that. I remember returning from the Sammelan with an overwhelming sense of optimism. Subsequent visits to the field have only reinforced that optimism and have also reinforced my faith in the strategies that Pradhan employs. Today, over 500 professionals work for Pradhan. Most of them work at the grassroots. Their efforts make Pradhan what it is. Our engagement extends to nearly 7,500 villages, reaching about 6 lakh households in 7 of the country's poorest states. Pradhanites work in very difficult and remote areas with commitment and with unflagging motivation. The excitement that they bring to their jobs, and this is what we've seen during our field visits to Pradhan areas, that the excitement that these professionals bring to their jobs is an inspiration. Since 2013, Pradhan has served as a national support organization for the flagship program of the government, the National Rural Livelihoods Mission. To extend and augment the impact of its work, Pradhan partners with organizations at multiple levels: civil society organizations, Panchayati Raj institutions, trusts and foundations, research institutes, central and state government departments, and corporate entities. In forging and running these partnerships, Pradhan carefully guards its values and the belief that change can be effective and sustainable only if developmental issues and challenges are viewed through the lens of the communities that we work with. So while Pradhan recognizes the need for plural development approaches for a country as diverse as ours, inclusion, participation, and mainstream linkages of communities at every stage of the development process will continue to be key. This means that if development is to sustain, various stakeholders need to talk to one another, and Samagam envisages just such an opportunity. We are optimistic that Samagam will become a space, and as Sukanya said, it will be a yearly feature, and we're hopeful that it will become a space in which we'll be able to shine a light on the variety of work that is being done in the development sector, and foster partnerships between the array of actors that are working in this field. This, we hope, will draw broader and more committed support for civil society initiatives. Samagam 2018 will open with a keynote address by Dr. Pratap Bhanu Mehta, the Vice Chancellor of Ashoka University. This will be followed by a discussion on the keynote. We will then go into thematic sessions. The first session will take stock of the role of civil society and the challenges before it today. The next two sessions will address the expectations of CSR agencies and the state from civil society organizations. In the final session, Vijay Mahajan will summarize the day's deliberations in terms of the way forward for civil society. Our keynote speaker this morning, Dr. Pratap Bhanu Mehta, is an eminent political scientist. He has published widely in the areas of political theory, governance and political economy, constitutional law, and international affairs. He has taught at Harvard, JNU, and the New York University School of Law. Dr. Mehta has been the president of the Center for Policy Research since July 2017. He is the vice chancellor of Ashoka University. Dr. Mehta has served on many Government of India committees, including the National Knowledge Commission. As we all know, he is a prolific writer, and he is also on the editorial boards of several academic journals of renown. Dr. Mehta received the 2010 Malcolm Adiseshaya Award, the 2011 Infosys Prize for Social Science, and the 2013 Amartya Sen Award for Social Science.